Hello friends, in the third lecture of organic chemistry, I heartily welcome all of you. Dear students, in the previous lecture, we have started to alkyl and aryl halides. We studied definition of alkyl halides, detailed classification of haloalkane and alkyl halides. Common name and IUPAC nomenclature of alkyl halides. In this lecture, we have planned to study some reactions of alkyl halides. Reactions such as SN1 reaction and its mechanism, SN2 reaction and its mechanism, SNI mechanism. Friends, let us start to the reactions of alkyl halides. We have seen that in the last lecture, I told you that this topic, alkyl and aryl halide, is divided into two parts, alkyl halides and aryl halides. In this topic, we have to study first alkyl halides, its reaction, its nomenclature, it's some compounds, etc. And in the second section, we are going to study aryl halides. What name of different types of aryl halides, its structure, its reaction, etc. So friends, reactions of alkyl halides are divided into three types. Nucleophilic substitution reaction of alkyl halides, elimination reactions, and reactions with some metals. In this lecture, we are going to study nucleophilic reaction of alkyl halides. You know, alkyl halides are nothing but monohalogen derivative of alkane. So, this compound shows nucleophilic substitution reaction betterly. So, first reaction which is shown by alkyl halide is SN1 reaction, substitution nucleophilic. So, what is meant by SN1 reaction? SN1 reaction means substitution nucleophilic. Let us consider this reaction. So, this is an alkyl halide. This is a 2-bromopropane. And when 2-bromopropane is reacted with any nucleophile Nu having a negative charge, it attacks on the carbon to which halogen atom is attached. This halogen atom is substituted by nucleophile Nu and Br- minus is get removed. Thus, this type of reaction is known as a nucleophilic substitution reaction of alkyl halide. Alkyl halide having a halogen, when replaced by any type of nucleophile to give new product, that is known as nucleophilic substitution reaction. So, nucleophilic substitution reactions are of 2 to 3 types. First one, SN1 reaction, SN2 reaction and SNI reaction. We are well familiar with these reactions. I think you are well familiar or you have studied this reaction in 12th science or in F5BSc. So friends, what is meant by SN1 reaction? The long form of SN1 is nothing but substitution nucleophilic unimolecular. Why this reaction is known as SN1 reaction? Because it's a rate of reaction is dependent on only concentration of substrate. Therefore, it is known as a unimolecular reaction. Let us try to apply this concept in mathematical form. Therefore, rate of compound is proportional to substrate. Therefore, rate is equal to K into substrate, where K is proportionality constant. For studying this reaction, the well familiar example is tertiary butyl bromide. When tertiary butyl bromide is reacted with aqueous alkali such as NaOH, KOH, it gives final product, that is alcohol, and this reaction follows SN1 reaction. How this reaction occur? Friend, this SN1 reaction of tertiary butyl bromide to give tertiary butanol, this reaction follow SN1 mechanism. SN1 mechanism is two-stepped mechanism. Actually, what happens in the first step? Initially, the substrate tertiary butyl bromide slowly get polarized. Its bond between carbon and bromine, carbon and any halogen atom slowly get polarized. There is a partial polarization of this bond and Br- get eliminated. And carbon having no any electron, all the electrons in between carbon and bromine get acquired by bromine. Therefore, carbon has no electron. It is electron deficient carbon, and therefore this carbon acquires positive charge, and any positively charged carbon is known as a carbonium ion. Thus, in the tertiary butyl reaction of tertiary butyl bromide by SN1 mechanism, first step consists of formation of carbonium ion. Thus, once carbonium ion is formed, as carbonium ion formation is very slow step, it is a rate determining step. In this step, formation of carbonium ion, this species is measured in rate determining step. As it is very slow step, it is considered as rate determining step. In rate determining step, as only tertiary butyl bromide is involved, therefore SN1 reaction is unimolecular reaction. Once carbonium ion is formed, this carbonium ion is planar one. All these CH3 groups are exist in one and the same plane, and carbon acquires positive charge, and therefore in second step, there is a fast attack of any nucleophile. In this case, we have taken aqueous NaOH, OH minus from NaOH, or H2O itself acts as a neutral nucleophile. As H2O having a lone pair of electron, it attacks on this carbon and it forms a bond like this. But water molecule having a two hydrogen, therefore in the next step what happens, the one of the proton attached to the oxygen atom is get removed, and negative charge or bonding electron pair are shifted on positively charged oxygen, and for this process another water molecule abstracts one of the proton, and thus there is a formation of tertiary butanol with water. So friends, so this is the short mechanism of SN1 reaction. Let us consider the stereochemistry of SN1 reaction. So friends, as we have seen that SN1 mechanism follow two-stepped mechanism. First step is formation of carbonium ion, and second step is attack of nucleophile. So this is the one example we have taken for studying stereochemistry of SN1 reaction. What is the name of this compound? So this is carbon CH3, this is CH2, this is again one carbon having a chlorine. This is CH2, this is CH2, This is again CH3. How many carbons are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Totally there are 6 carbon, and chlorine is attached to the third carbon, and again one there is one methyl group to the third carbon. Therefore, IUPAC name of this compound is 3-chloro-3-methyl-hexane. So this is one compound. This is a starting compound. This is alkyl halide. And see this structure. This carbon to which chlorine is attached. This carbon having a four groups. First chlorine, second dotted CH2CH3, wedged group CH3, and normal line having a CH2CH2CH3. Friends, if you observe keenly, carefully, it is observed that this central carbon having a four different types of group. So this carbon is said to be chiral center. What is chiral center? Chiral center means this is the carbon to which four different groups are attached. And chiral compound always shows optical activity. And R and S are the optical isomers of any compound. So this is the S compound, S enantiomer. What is meant by optical isomerism, or what is meant by R and S isomers in optical activity? These are the compounds. These are the optical isomers which are non-superimposable mirror images of each other. So thus, enantiomers means these are the optical isomers which are non-superimposable mirror images of each other. Friends, we have taken this example. Just I have told you the name of this compound, 3-chloro-3-methyl-hexane. When this compound is allowed to react by SN1 reaction, there is a formation of carbocation, carbonium ion. This chlorine is get removed slowly in red determining step. There is a formation of carbocation. It is a planar one. All this ethyl group, methyl group, and again this N-propyl group exist in one and the same plane, and Cl- is get removed. So we are going to learn stereochemistry of SN1 reaction. And we have taken I minus as a nucleophile in this case. As this carbocation is planar one, all these three groups are exist in one and the same plane. This I minus having a opportunity from both side to attack on this central carbon atom. When I attack from the same side where chlorine was attached, see, this is the chlorine. Chlorine was to the right hand side, and this blue line indicates the right hand side. When I attacks from right hand side, or where it is also known as a frontal sides, chlorine or any halogen atom attached to carbon, that side is always known as a frontal side, and the back side of this chlorine, so this side is known as a back side. So I may attack from frontal side, I may attack from back side. This red arrow shows back side attack. Thus, when I attack from left hand side, it is denoted by a red arrow, and there is a formation of this compound. What is this? This is a, again, 3-iodo-3-methyl-hexane. But here in starting compound, we have shown S enantiomers, S compound. But in this compound, we have shown R enantiomers. S and R compounds are opposite compound. They are optical isomers of each other. Thus, we can say that whatever the configuration was to the starting compound is get changed, because here there was a s, and in this case there is a r. As I attack from backside, all these three groups are get inverted to this side, therefore we get a r enantiomer. We can say that there is a inversion of configuration. Some of the nucleophilic molecule of iodine may attack from the left back side to give inverted configuration. Friends, when I attack from the same side where chlorine was attached, so what will happen? See here. So I attack from right side, the same side from the chlorine. So when it attacks, carbonium ion is formed and iodine attack from the same side where chlorine was there. So we get this compound. Again, this compound is 3-iodo-3-methyl-hexane, and this is S enantiomers. Starting compound was S and final product is also S. Therefore, we can conclude that whatever the configuration in first compound is retained in the product, therefore there is a retention of configuration. Therefore, in SN1 reaction, some of the molecule of the products are formed as a inverted configuration as a R enantiomer, and some of the product is formed as a S with respect to starting compound, that is retain the configuration. Therefore, there is a formation of mixture, and this mixture is in different proportion. Sometimes we get a 50-50 proportion, sometimes we get a 60-40 proportion, and net result of this reaction or stereochemistry of SN1 reaction, we can say that there is a not completely 100% inversion, not completely retention. Therefore, there is a formation of mixture, and thus we can't predict the exact stereochemistry of certain reactions. So this is about the stereochemistry of SN1 reaction. It depends upon reaction to reaction. So in some reactions, we get a retention of configuration, more percentage of retention of configuration, and in some reactions we get a inversion of configuration, or some reactions there is 50-50%. Thus, this is the brief discussion about stereochemistry of SN1 reaction. Friends, after this, let us come to the SN2 reaction. So what is meant by SN2 reaction? SN2 reaction means substitution nucleophilic bimolecular. So in this reaction, in this reaction bond formation and bond breaking occur simultaneously or synchronously. Thus, two reacting species are involved in the rate determining step of the reaction. The term SN2 stands for substitution nucleophilic bimolecular, and thus this reaction is very familiar in alkyl halides. Let us consider the reaction, example of this reaction, SN2 reaction. So this is one example. What is this? CH3CH2Cl when reacted with Br- as a nucleophile. One can take OH- aqueous NaOH, aqueous KOH, but in this case we have taken Br- as a nucleophile. So this reaction follow SN2 path, and thus this is the transition state of this reaction. In transition state, incoming nucleophile is also exist, as well as this starting compound is also exist. As both are involved in rate determining step, for formation of transition state we have to react starting compound as well as nucleophile. As both are involved in rate determining step, this is known as a bimolecular reaction, SN2 reaction. So let us observe the transition state of this reaction. In transition state, bromine, when a reaction is done, when Br- is mixed with the starting compound, Br- slowly start to form bond with central carbon atom, where halogen, another leaving group is attached, and there is a partial bond formation in between carbon and bromine. And at the same time, this carbon-chlorine bond is slowly get depart. There is a departure of this bond, and this is a this occurs at certain energy at activated state. Therefore, this is known as a transition state. And once there is acquirement of, there is a gain of certain energy, Cl minus is get removed, and there is a formation of Br minus. This product, final product. Thus, if you observe the starting compound and this final compound, this chlorine is attached to the right hand side with respect to this carbon. But this carbon having a bromine, incoming Br minus from the left hand side. Therefore, this is left hand side, and this chlorine leaving group is from right hand side. As this side, two sides are opposite, you may say that there may be inversion in configuration. So let us consider the stereochemistry of SN2 reaction. SN2 reactions show purely 100% inversion in stereochemical configuration. It is clear that these reactions occur through backside attack. As I earlierly mentioned that SN1 reaction does not follow 100% inversion or 100% retention of configuration. There is a mixture formation, and sometimes it is also referred as a racemization. We may say racemization. It depends upon proportion of highest proportion of product. Friends, after SN1 and SN2, third type of nucleophilic substitution reaction is also observed in some cases. That type of nucleophilic substitution reaction you might not have studied yet. So third type is SNI reaction. The meaning of SNI reaction is substitution nucleophilic internal. For this mechanism, when thionyl chloride is allowed to react with alcohol, it form alkyl chlorosulfite, and this alkyl chlorosulfite, once form, it form intimate ion pair, and finally there is a formation of product. But this mechanism is quite different. So see here, this is a alcohol, tertiary butanol, and when tertiary butanol is allowed to react with thionyl chloride, what happens here? Oxygen having a lone pair of electron, it attacks on this sulfur, and one of the chlorine is get removed here as a Cl minus, and this O oxygen of tertiary butanol get attached to the sulfur. There is a formation of bond between sulfur and oxygen, and one H is as it is there. Therefore, O acquires positive charge. So, Cl- get removed here. And in next step, what happens? This EH is extra. Therefore, bonding electron between this oxygen and EH gets shifted like this on positive charge. And thus, there is a removal of EH plus here. And thus, there is a formation of this type of intermediate. And lastly, what happens here, this there is a chlorine, and this chlorine attack internally from the same side. This bond is get shifted here, this bond is get shifted here, carbon bond between carbon and oxygen get shifted to the bond between in between oxygen and sulfur, this chlorine is get removed as a Cl minus, and this Cl minus get attacked from the same side where oxygen is attached. This chlorine attacks internally, you may say internally, therefore there is a attachment of chlorine internally, and that's why this mechanism is known as a nucleophilic substitution internal, and there is a formation of this compound pH. You may take here CH3 or pH. If you take CH3, then you will get tertiary butanol. If you take a pH here, there will be this compound, derivative of this ethane. So we get a 1-phenyl ethyl chloride. So any example you can take for studying substitution nucleophilic internal SNI mechanism. So after this, friends, we are going to study next reaction regarding this SNI mechanism. So this is the alcohol, this is R, this is again R, this is a H, this is OH, this OH attacks on the sulfur, this is a thionyl chloride, and once this electron attack on sulfur, there is a removal of one Cl, and H and Cl liberated as a HCl, and there is a formation of this twice R, H and carbon O, SO, Cl. This is a intermediate compound, and this intermediate compound reacts in different way. See, first type of reaction, HCl is get liberated. This HCl reacts with this intermediate compound. This is the central carbon where substitution occur. Thus, Cl attacks from this side, back side, with respect to this OH. OH is a leaving group here, and Cl attacks from back side, this side. Therefore, there is an inversion of configuration, and attack of this Cl occurs by SN2 way, substitution nucleophilic bimolecular, and there is a formation of inversion of product. Let us consider the second reaction here, when same intermediate molecule reacted with 1,4-dioxane. So this is the 1,4-dioxane, and this dioxane acts as a nucleophile. There is a removal of this dioxane attacks from the back side, this group is get removed, and there is a formation of this intermediate, and again this chlorine may attack from the backside, and there is this chlorine attacks by SN2 path, and there is a retention of configuration. This chlorine get bonded to the central carbon atom where OH was there. Thus, the configuration of this starting compound and configuration of this compound is remain same. Therefore, retention of configuration. This is the SN2 reaction. How this intermediate molecule react in different way? See here. When same reaction is carried out in pyridine, it form pyridine acts as a nucleophile here, and HCl is get removed. Pyridine get attached to sulfur, and this chlorine, which is liberated here in this reaction, attacks from the backside, and again this part is get removed, and Cl get attached from the backside, and final, see the configuration of final product. It is an inversion of configuration. Friends, we are concerned with SNI mechanism. So this intermediate molecule, we have taken this molecule. What is SNI? SNI means substitution nucleophilic internal. So this molecule and this molecule is same. So what happens? the bond between this carbon and oxygen get polarized, carbon acquires positive charge, this bond gets shifted here, and this chlorine attacks, get removed here and get attacks as a Cl minus internally. This is mentioned earlierly. Thus Cl minus get attacked from the same side here, and thus as there is internal attack of chlorine, it is known as SNI mechanism, and there is a retention of configuration. Thus we can say that SNI reaction follow in retention of configuration. What is the stereochemistry of SNI? SNI reaction, substitution nucleophilic internal reaction follow retention of configuration. Friends, with this we are going to study some reactions, further some reactions, but that reaction we'll discuss later on. Friends, I think you understand this reaction. Thank you very much. Stay home, stay healthy, take care. Thank you very much.